Hi everybody, it's Grace, back with another video. If this is your first time seeing my face, hearing my name, or stumbling upon this channel, welcome to the fam. However, if you are a returning subscriber, you already know the vibes. Thank you for tuning in for another video. I'm back with Nelson. You all seem to enjoy him so much the last few times he's on my channel. I figured it's only right, since the goat is back and this is his goat. One of my goats as well, but his, I'd actually see him cry today.
Hey, she said it, not me.
Anyways, we need to get into this because I mean, like, it's been...
I don't get to give a little intro. Cool. You know, it's been 5 years. This is my favorite rapper. Like, this is my guy. Like, K-Dot, Kenny Lamar, Kung Fu, like, he's back. You know what I'm saying? I got worldly expectations, but you know, I'm here with unbiased ears. I'm just ready to hear what we in for. He dropped The Heart Part 5 earlier this week. This was amazing. Yeah, he hasn't missed a beat. You could tell my man's probably been depressed. He's probably really looking at the lowly state of the world of what we've been going through the past 5 years. And I think he's ready to preach to us. My boy's got a crown of thorns on his head. You know what I'm saying? He's got the Messiah complex right now. He's ready. He's here to save us. You know what I'm saying? I think we got the album of the year right here before I even heard a thing. So let's see. Let's see what we're working with.
Well, we're just going to get right on into it. I'm excited. You're excited. We're all excited. It's time. This is the first song. It's just called United in Grief.
That just sounds sad as hell. And it's a double album, by the way. We're getting two sides, the Mr. Morale and the Big Stepper side. So let's see. I'm assuming this is the Mr. Morale side. So let's dive in.
Tell them the truth.
I hope you find some paradise.
I love you.
I've been going through something.
Me too.
1,855 days. I've been going through something.
Huh.
Be afraid.
What is a bitch in a miniskirt? A man in his feelings were bitter. What is a woman that really hurt? A demon, you're better off killing her. Instead of you, a family broken in variables. What is a rebel with jewelry? A way that I show my maturity. You know my head is wild. Shaking and moving like, what am I doing? I'm flipping my time to the Rolodex. Indulging myself in my life and my music. The word that I'm in is... I met her on the third night of Chicago. Looked the mirror between my eyes glow. B-5-4-4, she was a model. Body asked me FaceTime. Clean that, said you be okay. First two or six, the pain away. I agree, different. Bought a couple of mansions, chef for practice. 500 in jewelry, chain was magic. Never had it in public, late reaction. 50K to cousins, post a caption. Pray none of my enemies hold me captive. So what? Paralyzed the county, but they controlled us.
Oh, I must start. Damn. There was a lot to unpack in that. You know, that was a loaded intro, to say the least. Listen, he warned us coming into this. New flows coming soon. Be patient, brother. You know what I'm saying? We seen a variety of flows throughout that shit, a variety of instrumentals. I can tell he's just on some different shit right now, where he's just like, a lot of the songs are probably going to be like non-linear. A lot of them are going to be just different sounding. Nothing, not going to know what to expect going from parts to part. And yeah, I mean, we're just talking about a lot of the different themes of grief, how we all deal with grief, all the people he's seen die at different stages of his life, how he deals with it. I definitely want to see what direction he takes. I knew he sounded depressed. It's giving that vibe.
Yeah. I mean, you kind of said it all. I don't really have anything else to say about that. It's a very good intro. Very captivating intro. Wasn't boring. He gave us a lot. I feel like every time I listen to that song, I'm going to find something new that I didn't notice the first time I listened to it. I hope writing this album gave him a chance to really, like, unpack all the shit that he's going through.
The next song is N95.
Hello, new world, all the boys and girls. I got some true stories to tell. You're back outside, but they still lie. Whoa.
Take off the fufu, take off the couches, take off the Wi-Fi, take off the uniform, take off the car loan, take off the flex and the white loss, alright, take off the condo, take off the sandro, pay 5 days, pay, take a photo, you know how to find me, take off the phone.
You ugly as fuck, you are a pocket, two
ATMs, and you stepping on what? You out pocket. Who you think they talk about us?
This nigga been kicking it with Keem too much, bro.
Yeah.
Baby Keem written all over it, bro.
From the ad-libs to the beat. You ugly as fuck. Okay. That's different.
That's just the Baby Keem influence is really...
Yeah, it's crazy.
Was all over that. And I don't know. I thought he was doing that because he was on Keem tracks, like with the old features. I thought he was like... adopting his shit and just like I felt like they were just having fun in the studio. Maybe like Keem really inspired him. He's like, well, no, let me try this, let me
dabble in this.
It's interesting. I mean, you know, it's good. It's good rapping. I mean, I know the rapping is gonna be good on every song, regardless or whatever.
Yeah, I just kind of hope that the rest of the album isn't like.
I pray it doesn't. It's not like that. Yeah,
I feel like Kendrick can do a couple of songs like that in a project, but if the whole project. Sound like, well, like if the Mr. Morale part sounds like that, it's like, what are you doing? Respectfully. Because yeah. I feel like he could take that good rapping and just like not.
Yeah. But he's just saying a lot of random shit, kind of. Like, it makes sense, but it's just, I don't know. I got to see where we keep going. I'm getting too deep into it early, but cool. All right. The next
one. Do you think the song is only cool because it's Kendrick? Or did you actually like the song?
What do you mean? I didn't say it was amazing or great.
No, I'm just asking. Like, are you just saying it's cool because it's Kendrick and you're excited for new Kendrick? Or because
that's a valid question.
If anyone else made that song, would you like it?
That's a very valid question. I don't know. If I'm objectively listening to it, like I would be like, I would say all the same things I just said. Like, it's good rapping. I feel like they're kind of saying random shit. The instrumental's interesting. I don't know what the replay value is going to be for me, like for that song, like in like a year. Like, am I like gonna be in the whip and I randomly like it's time for N95? I don't know. So that goes to whether it's Kendrick or not. That's just how I feel. So I feel like even if someone else did that, that would be my take on it. Worldwide Steppers, track 3.
Kodak Black. Okay, Lama.
This is the song he's
ain't
on.
Hard, told
you.
Damn.
And
no, this I is know, but there's the a song that's featuring Kodak Black.
Doesn't say that.
Playing baby shark with my daughter, watching for sharks outside at the same time. Life as a protective father, I kill for my son Enoch is the part two. When I inspire my children to make higher valleys. In this present moment, I saw that through I'm from. I don't think like I used to. No, I don't blink like I used to. Aqua stares at everybody. See the flesh of man, but still this man compared to nobody. Heavy sciatica nerve pinch. I don't know how to feel. Like the first time I fucked a white bitch.
Oh.
Yo.
The first time I fucked a white bitch, I was 16 at the Palisades, fumbling my graves. I traveled with the team, the Apache life. I fucked a white bitch, was out in Copenhagen. Good kid, Man City tour. I flourished on them stages. When he asked, did I have a problem? I said I might be racist. Ancestors watching me fuck was like retaliation. I'm a killer, he's a killer, she's a killer bitch. We some killers walking zombies trying to scratch that itch. Germophobic, head up on homophobic. Photoshop and lies and motives. Hide your eyes and pose for the pic. Teach your philosophies. You either go be dead or in jail. Killer psychology. Silent murderer. What's your body count? Who your sponsorship? Objective.
So far, like, this album sounds like a poetry slam.
Get out of my house. Literally just
Like, I literally...
Oh, like, spoken word.
Literally, like, I feel like he's Cynthia. On a stick. Jesus died for our Cynthia's.
Jesus died, runaway bride.
I literally feel like he's on stage. Like, some nigga is just, like, on the piano. Just hitting shit. And he's just, like, going
one
in.
One of his Kendrick dances.
Yeah.
All these songs, well, we're only on the third song, but they've all felt like interludes.
Yeah, like...
Like, none of the songs, they don't feel really, like, complete songs.
Yeah. He's, like... I don't know. He's just, like, unloading.
I mean, shit, he's got 5 years worth of shit to get off his chest.
Word, but, like, I don't know. These don't even feel like songs.
They do feel kind of manic. Like, all these songs kind of have a manic vibe.
Like, it's definitely, like, thought-provoking shit, and he'd be asking, like, thought-provoking questions and, like... The parallels are really there and interesting.
It makes you think because he's saying shit that like no one is saying.
It definitely got better at the second half. And I'm not gonna lie, like in the beginning, I thought that shit was trash.
I did too.
Because a lot of it wasn't rhyming too. So I was just like, oh man, he's just like.
Speaking.
He's really just saying shit. And I was like, when's the song gonna start? And then at some point, it just started to rhyme and then somehow turned into a song. Then it was a beat switch. Then it went back to the other beat.
Yeah, I didn't really like that part. I didn't like how the beat switched and then it went back to what he was doing before.
Yeah, he should have wrote out the other beat.
I was more so paying attention to the lyrics. I was trying to figure out what he was talking about and the beat was kind of throwing me off. But then the beat switch, I was like, oh, okay, that's cool. And then, I don't know, he just went back to what he was doing before, which kind of lost me a little bit. But he was saying some real shit.
It was weird having Kodak talk in the beginning and then just he goes.
Especially when there's a song with Kodak.
What was the
on there?
Significance of Kodak giving the intro. The song is cool again, you know. I don't know what the replay value really is gonna be. I mean, there was potential for that chorus. If it was a different like instrumental, he really could have like went hard on that shit. I'm a killer, he's a killer, she's a killer bitch. He could have like just went on that shit, like kept using that flow, and so that would have been like,
you know, hard. Who could have been a good feature on that?
Who?
Tyler. Like that aggressive like register he gets in.
Yeah.
He could have had him like as a surprise feature on there, like,
yeah,
on that part.
Yeah. That was interesting. It was interesting. I'm reserving judgment. We're still pushing through. Die Hard is the next song featuring Blast and Amanda Reifer.
Who's Amanda Reifer?
I don't know. Oh. We love Blast in this house, though, so let's see how you fit in on here.
You stand. I pop the pain away.
Alright, I'm getting song vibes.
Song vibes?
This feels like a song.
I hope I'm not too late. Set my demons straight. I know I made you wait.
Yeah, this gonna be tough.
If I told you who I am, would you use it against me? Right or wrong, no stone, just love to send me. I hope I'm not too late. Set my demons straight.
Definitely the best song so far.
Agreed.
Shit has like chorus, verses. Not like that I'm against
a bridge.
Not that I'm against non-traditional song structure, but like
time and a place.
It was just welcoming. Like, you know, I feel like I'm listening to like album, you know, that was.
And not just like thoughts, scattered thoughts.
I felt like Kendrick's rapping, like he wasn't really trying to rap. He was kind of like vibing with the song.
Yeah, I think Blast was definitely the best part of the song.
Yeah, for sure.
I did enjoy Kendrick's rapping and what he had to say. I just don't think like the voice that he chose, like, I don't know how I feel about that on the song.
It was melodically driven. He was like, you know, using his voice to like, you know, hit the notes with his verse. Yeah. But I feel like, you know.
I know, but I feel like if he had just rapped regularly, it would have been fine.
Yeah.
Not like the aggressive rap, but you know, like when Kendrick just like kind of like chills a little bit.
It could have like gave like All the Stars vibes.
Yeah. Basically, yeah.
Yeah, cool. That could have been a little.
Yeah. Did you like the song, Prince? Great talk. So, I did like that. I like the song though.
That was a good song. So let's see. I'll say nothing has like blown me away yet. You're gonna see. I mean, my reaction, you'll know. That was, you know, everything. It's cool.
It's been cool so far.
It's been cool. Track 5, Father Time, featuring Sampha.
Life is a plot, twisted from directions that I can't see. Daddy issues run across my head. Tell me fuck a foul, I'm teary-eyed. Running through my hands, I won't think out loud. A foolish pride, if I lose again, won't go in the house, I stand outside. Laughing with my friends, they don't know my life. Daddy issues made me bad losses. I don't take those well. Mama said that boy is exhausted. He said go fuck yourself.
Cops practicing on theos. Tough love, I'm bubbled up. No chase on me, no chase on me.
Shit about being a man.
was everything I was.
Early morning wake ups, practicing on chaos, tough love.
Best song so far.
Agreed. And that felt very complete.
Easily. Great instrumental, great subject matter. See, that's like, once again, like, I'm not trying to harp on the traditional song structure thing, but literally that was just like great chorus, great verse, like.
Sounds like a Kendrick
instrumental
song.
Was very valid, fit the theme. Like, that's a great song. That's just great rapping, great storytelling, gets us inside his head, you know, gets us into his upbringing, how it shows how he moves throughout the now, throughout current times, like how it's influenced who he is now. Like, that was good. That's the shit I want to hear.
I like it. I like when he does songs like that. Like, he'll start off doing something, but then, like, the very last verse brings it all full circle, the storytelling aspect of it. I like Kendrick songs like that.
That was fire.
He executes it perfectly every single time.
Rich and Awood.
I learned in trapping in the business, smart people making horrible decisions, you know? Rich nigga get my dick sucked after the show. I ain't gonna lie, we were cold. A bunch of lost souls in survival mode. There wasn't no way for us unless we find our own. Running in stones, kicking in doors, nigga, give me my glory. Nigga, play with me, he ain't gonna live to tell a story. Gas in the hood, dropping all plates in the ground like Thanksgiving. Got the baby sniper standing on that murk business, yeah, it's live for that. They ready for whatever. Always knew that everything would get better. Better than the OG. You gotta get it somewhere. Gotta come from something. Gotta come from nothing. We ain't seen this coming, it's more than a blessing. What you doing with Kendrick? What you doing with a legend? So what they call.
I'm really interested in.
Why?
In Kendrick's interest in Kodak. I've never knew there was even, I don't know. I
didn't, a line of communication.
I never thought Kendrick would have acknowledged Kodak's existence. And the fact that he's sprinkling him on the album, not even listing him, is an interesting choice. It's a cool interlude. I mean, he's just talking about getting out the mud. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's a good example, you know?
I feel like I'm watching a play.
Yeah, like, yeah, it's, yeah. It's, yeah.
I don't really have much to say about that.
Yeah.
I mean,
it was cool. Cool contribution from Kodak, you know? He's speaking, rhyming at the same time. Like, it's another, like, poetry thing. The next song is Rich Spirit, so let's see how that ties in.
Be cool, write testament, paint pictures, put me in the loop. That's a definite universal shift. I'm in the groove. It's celebrity, do not mean integrity, fool. I'm a good man, shake your hand, firm grip rules. Bitch nigga, broke phone, trying to keep the balance. I'm staying strong. Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song. Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song. Hey, bitch, I'm attractive. Can't fuck with you no more. I'm fasting. Bitch, I'm attractive. Keep fuck. I'd be lying if I said I wouldn't get a shit away. Be a new Buddha, I'm Christ with a shooter. Praise to Muhammad, I might make a loser. AP gun, broke phone. Trying to keep the balance, I'm staying strong. Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song. Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song. Hey, bitch, I'm attractive. Keep fucking with rap, brother. We headed there now, are you strapped, brother? Peacemaker, but I'm not naive, brother. Actually pray when somebody dies. Thoughts and prayers, way better off timelines. False claiming, not cute, I'm mortified. The new earth and how pursuit 200 lives. Bitch nigga, broke phone. Trying to keep the balance.
It was cool. Another song that I felt like was just kind of okay. I didn't think it was bad. I think it just like, I don't really know how to describe it. I'm trying to be really unbiased, but it just sounds like, it really just sounds like he's been spending a lot of time with Baby Keem.
Yeah, that was definitely another Baby Keem influenced heavy ass song. Very much the flow, the shit he's saying. Yeah, bro, it was cool. Like, I have yet to be blown away by a song without a feature yet, which is kind of like, they aren't bad. Like, I can't isolate any bad songs, but it's just like, what am I really gonna put that on?
Definitely an open mic night beat.
I swear I'm tired of these emotional ass, ungrateful ass bitches. Unstable ass, confrontational ass, dumb bitches. You wanna bring a nigga down, even when I'm trying to do right. We can go our separate ways right now. You gon' move on with your life.
Fuck you, nigga, you love a pity party. I won't show up. Oh,
bitches love saying that shit.
Oh shit, I should've sucked
his.
What you said?
I should've found a bigger dick. I do the same when we fuck.
Act like that pussy ain't loose.
I'd rather act like I'm coming.
I'd rather fuck off the juice.
I'd rather fuck on your cousin.
Bitch, you said you gon' fuck who?
You heard me, nigga, it's nothing.
You know what?
Reason bitches start fucking with bitches when they change. You the reason bitches start calling y'all bitches cause y'all losers. You the reason Harvey Weinstein had to see his conclusion. You the reason R. Kelly can't recognize that he's a
musician. Shut the fuck up, I know you still playing this music. Said I'm tired of these emotional ass, ungrateful ass bitches. Bitch, I'm walking out.
Whatever, nigga, I'm off to
your
now.
Your evil ass can't be well in doubt.
Pussy nigga, best watch your mouth.
Pussy and mouth is all you got.
Lay this pussy back on the couch.
Doggy style, then you get on top.
Fuck me, nigga.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
No, fuck me, nigga, fuck me.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
No, fuck you, fuck me.
Stop tap dancing around the conversation.
That was a good song.
It was a good song. I think it's a good song. I just don't know in what setting I would listen to that.
When you're playing the album straight through, basically.
Yeah. I mean, it'd be like that sometimes.
Everybody heard combos like that, bits and pieces. You know, a lot of this shit was, yeah, man, you know, hurt people. That's really how this shit go. You argue, say disrespectful shit to each other, fucking make up.
It'd be like that sometimes.
That shit was...
That's all you can kind of say.
There's only one song left on Side A.
My girl is featured on that.
I want to see how everything ties together, how I'm going to look at Side A. Because Side A is... It's interesting. It's just a lot of things going on. A lot of different topics that he's talking about. I just kind of need to, like, tie it together.
I thought it was a good song. That song also felt complete. And then the ending, like, stop tap dancing around the conversation. That was a nice little... thing in there.
Purple Hearts featuring Summer Walker and Ghostface Killah. Man's got Ghostface on this bitch. That's crazy. Let's see, man.
This gonna be the one.
Keep it on and I'm all walking. Rolling sevens, I ain't ready for no coffee. I know y'all love it when the girls talking, but shut the fuck up when you hear love talking. Shut the fuck up when you hear love talk.
Who's like when you not tripping? Lined up the body. Who said they saw me? Crown on by Molly. Wrist on your body. They gon' judge your life for a couple nights on the double tap. Them hoes is solid. I'm blessed that you can learn from a loss. I'm blessed that you heal. I bless one day that you attract somebody with your mind exact. A patient life. Frost bless them twice and then bless you back. Keep it going and I'm all walk. Rolling sevens, I ain't back for no coffee. I know you're loving when the dogs come. Shut the fuck up when you hear love talking. Yeah, baby.
Ooh.
Yeah. How's love putting his heart to your soul?
What the fuck is Ghostface gonna do on this?
Left his ass on the road. Gossiping about some shit you don't know.
Reckless in a single gleam. Shut the fuck up when you hear his love talking. To the mind is God's cipher, divine in a small portion. Bow your head for just God's sake. Listen what the stars say when I say it's God's way.
Keep it going and I'm on a walk. Rolling sevens, I ain't ready for no coffee.
I like that song. That shit was fire.
That's a great way to end Side A, for sure. I like how, you know, the song before you get like the heat of the argument and then it closes like with them making up and then you get the love song after. He's getting carried by the features though.
Yeah. I was about to say another song that I liked.
He's getting carried by features. He's getting carried by the features. Summer carried that Ghostface verse was very, very nice. Very nice. I had a feeling it was gonna be like they was gonna like pull most of the instrumental back and kinda just like let him rap over it. That was tough.
I don't really see how he would have fit on there otherwise.
Yeah.
The first song on Side B, it's called Count Me Out.
Done, that's one of you now, but the father's son. Till then I fight, rain on me, put the blame on me. Got guilt, got hurt, got shame on me. Rather these dust, I lack in trust. This time around I trust myself. Please everybody else but myself. All those fails, I was myself. Out there fear, I've been deprived. Even my strong points couldn't survive. If I didn't learn to love myself, forgive myself 100 times, down. I love when you count me out. 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 Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fucking it up. I don't wear my shorts on the bathroom deep. I don't bitch on love when the bed don't sleep. Always tell me where the pros was at. 3:30 in the morning, scroll through the call up. Ain't nobody but the mirror looking for the fall off.
Yeah, that was tough.
I feel like that sounds more like an intro than the intro to the album.
Yeah.
Like the way the beat built.
And yeah.
Built. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So I feel like probably the first side is going to be more, what is supposed to represent more the shit in the world that he's dealing with, that he's observing, that he's noticing. And then like the second side is kind of more like, all right, this is who I am. Like at least from the first song, you know, it's kind of like more of a prideful, uplifting.
Acceptance.
Like, like really kind of accepting his situation. Next song, Crown. These pianos, bro.
Very play vibes.
Favor come with favors and you can't see. And I can't please everybody. No, I can't please everybody. Wait, you can't please everybody. No, I can't please everybody. One thing I've learned, love can change with the seasons. And I can't please everybody. No, I can't please everybody.
All right, maybe my statement was wrong, because he's clearly still going through it, and he's like clearly feeling the pressures of everyone's expectations weighing on him. Once again, I like what he's talking about, but like he said what he wanted to say on it. I just feel like it's not like a song. Like it is a
That's
song.
That's what I'm saying. Like it doesn't. It's giving like.
It's a complete idea, though.
Okay, you can have a complete idea and your song still doesn't feel complete.
I guess. I don't know. I feel like it just doesn't sound like a song. I feel like it's two different things. I think.
Most of the songs sound with just him sound like it's just a score.
Yeah, like.
And he just like took a concept or a theme that he wanted to talk about, wrote down some ideas on it, and then put it over a piano.
I'm trying to play this in the car or my AirPods. I'm saying I'm not gonna lay in my bed like just chilling and just throw this shit on while I'm like The next song is Silent Hill.
Kodak.
Yak.
Push these niggas off me like, push these bitches off me like, push these niggas off me like,
this keen ass nigga.
Know the results, the ballot is in, and I'm about to boom again. You funny, dog.
Oh, man.
I ran my whole conglomerate. I was just matching shit out in the cooker. Studio on K-Live, fresh out of bed. Yeah, you niggas can't stand the rain. Niggas don't stand a chance. Yeah, shit like candy pain. I spend a bit in the band.
Never thought I'd see the day Kendrick is watched by Kodak.
Yeah, Kodak definitely carried. That beat was hard as fuck, though.
I can name on, like, half a finger how many times Kendrick's been washed, like, in his career. Like, what the fuck, bro? This is so weird. Like,
he was also giving the Baby Keem flow again.
And it's just, like, it's not even, like, as good as Baby Keem would have done it. Like, it's... If this was, like, a Baby Keem song, Kodak have the same verse, the same feature, but Baby Keem did whatever he wanted to do on the beat, it probably would have been, like, hard as fuck.
Yeah. Yeah. Still haven't been, like... mind blown yet. Yeah,
I just don't get like what he's going for, because it's like the songs with the most content are frantic and non-linear. Like, it's just a lot of fucking...
A lot going on.
Extreme instrumentals, extreme flows, going from the next flow, going to the next whatever. And that's when he's talking about the most shit. Then we get on to the catchy songs that you could tell he's trying to be, like, more...
Hip.
Commercial, hip, yeah. And
he's not saying
shit,
anything.
He's not really saying shit, and it's just, like, weird. Man, Savior Interlude is next, man.
Not on my birthday.
The first and the 15th, the only religion. Fools in the microwave, Shark Tank, Tidal Wave, Grandma shooting niggas blood on the highway, crust on the dashboard. You just want a platform. I want to take everything that I ask for. Catch me a body, I put that on.
You don't like it?
No, I was making that face about what you said.
Catch us, you know I'm going back up. I need the advance and the equity.
I feel like we can't stop after this. I feel like it has to flow right into the next song. We can just review both of them together.
Nowadays I'm a new prophet. Hey, gang, gang, no, I'm toxic. It's 4 eyes, 4 eyes, 2 eyes. Switch eyes, nigga be fresh out. Suicide doors, I suicide, suicide. Level body, who gon' stop me? Baby, Keem is too wild.
Cole made you feel empowered, but he is not your savior. Future said get a money counter, but he is not your savior. Ron made you give his flowers, but he is not your savior. He is not your savior.
Wait a minute, Ben Aki, Ben Aki, C'est la vie, C'est la vie. I tell the whole truth from A to Z.
Okay.
That was good.
I like that song.
I love the subject matter of that song.
Me too.
That like the way niggas be idolizing every kind of celebrity, all these like, and to the point where it gets weird, you know what I'm saying? And that they like literally
extreme dick
adopt their like behaviors and shit. Like it's and like the perspective of being the person that's being idolized and having that shit put on you, like, is so, especially like you don't even know the first thing about what these niggas really be on. Like, I like the rapping on that. I like the verses.
I was a fan of the interlude. I liked Keem's contribution on that.
Yeah, the interlude was tough. The interlude was very tough. Was-
I think people tend to lose sight of the fact that celebrities are humans too. They have other shit going on and outside of their career, just like we all have shit going on outside of our careers.
He's just saying, like, at the end of the day, these niggas ain't gonna save you. You feel me? The next song is called Auntie Diaries.
Oh, so much pain. My back hurts.
The mob can't say it, hot place, wait, the mob can't.
Monty is a man now. I think I'm old enough to understand now. Chinky Parmesan with her hat turned backwards. Motorola Pager off white guest jacket. Blue Air Max is a gold chain. My auntie is a man now. I asked my mama why my uncles don't like him that much. And at the parties, why they always want to fight him that much. She said, ain't no telling. Niggas always been jealous because he had more women. More money and more attention with no filter. However, my auntie became a man and I took pride in it. She wasn't gay, she ate pussy and that was the difference. That's what I told my friends in second grade. She picking me up from school, they stare at her in the face. They the window, cameras on the microphone. All women and men know my auntie was a man now. We cool with it, the history had trickled down. It made us ignorant, kids with no filter. However, I had to be very mindful of my good cousin. I knew exactly who he was, but I still loved him. Demetrius and Marianne now. I mean, he's really Marianne. Even took things further, changed his gender before Bruce Jenner was certain. Living his truth, even if it meant seeing surgery. We didn't talk for a while, he seemed more.
Can say with me, you say Kendrick ain't no room for contradiction. To truly understand love, switch position. Faggot, 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 we can say it together. But only if you let a white girl say nigga.
See.
Snap. He snapped.
I can't believe he brought up when he brought up that white girl on stage.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I didn't think he was ever going to rap about that. That's cool. Yeah. That's really cool.
That was a very progressive song.
Yeah, it was very interesting content, for sure.
Was not expecting that. I've been thinking also about how he's going to be at Rolling Loud.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I wonder what that set is going to be like.
Yeah, like, how can you even, you can't even really, like, perform this. Like, I feel like this isn't even,
how
like
do you,
a,
what do you do, like, as someone in the crowd, what do you, how
this,
do you.
This is not, like, a performative album. Like, I know he's never been one to, like, seek out radio shit. I mean, probably the most he ever did was on his last album.
Damn.
But, like, yeah. this shit has, like, no radio content. Like, not even close. No. Like, not even, like.
I feel like the closest thing would be the song with Blast.
The next song is called Mr. Morale.
If it's a two-part project, why was this song not? Never mind.
It was one of the worst performances I've seen in my life. I couldn't sleep last night because I got this shit.
The joke of this heavy. One life to give on the men like you ready. We'll keep them honest like us.
I wasn't really a big fan of that.
Besides the chorus, which was terrible, I think that energy on the verses would have been welcome on other songs. Like, I feel like I like when he's just like, his voice is very much in the forefront of the track.
And it's like not getting drowned out by the instrumental.
Not even necessarily that, but just like the instrumental complements the verse and the flow he's using. Like, it was just like very momentous. Like, it was very strong and powerful. And I feel like just a lot of shit, he was like either like whispering or like in the upper register. Like, he'd be like, he's just doing like a lot of goofy sounds and voices and unorthodox flows and shit. And I felt like a flow like that, like, I don't want to say it was simple, but it was like very straightforward. Like, it was just, and it was just like very present and at the forefront of the song. And I just felt like other songs, maybe like if he was rapping like that, I would have enjoyed them more entertaining. But this one, the beat was trash and the chorus was trash. So I even like the verses, like, even though like I kind of like that style of rapping, it still like wasn't, it just didn't come together for me. That one wasn't.
Song was not it.
Yeah. His next song is 7 fucking minutes.
Six minutes and 46 seconds.
It's basically 7 minutes. So I hope to God it's good. Yeah. Mother I Sober featuring Beth Gibbons of Portishead. Never heard of that or her, but let's see.
One man standing on 2 words, healed everybody. Transformation, then reciprocation. Karma must return. Family ties, they accused my cousin. Did he touch you, Kendrick? Never lied, but no one believed me when I said he did it. Frozen moments, still holding on it. Hard to trust myself. Failed to mention insecurities that I project. Sleeping with other women. Whitney's hurt, the pure soul I know. I found it in the kitchen. Asking God, where did I lose myself? And can it be forgiven?
You broke a generational curse. Say thank you, Dad.
Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Mommy.
Aw.
Thank you, Brother.
You always got an awesome shit.
Mr. Mola.
This shit really is giving much.
That was so heavy.
Play.
Yeah.
This shit really is literally a fucking play.
Yeah.
He's really, like, just tackling different, like, issues and topics and just getting on his soapbox. And it's, like, I don't know. Like, to say I did, like, enjoy the song. In the beginning, I kind of wasn't really fucking with it. I liked the progression. I liked the... I had a feeling he was going to kind of get more aggressive towards the end with the delivery. Obviously, once again, really powerful subject matter. Kendrick being a very private person, I do appreciate getting perspective. It's about him, his family, why he thinks the way he is. This is definitely probably like maybe is pretty close to probably his most personal. I mean, all his shit be personal.
No, this album is like super vulnerable.
No, this is extremely personal and vulnerable.
Especially
and, like,
that song.
He's being extremely transparent. A lot. And I can appreciate it. But at the same time, like, I don't like...
It definitely feels like a play about his life and thought process rather than an album. I think,
but just
personally.
In terms of, like, the songs, like, themselves and how they combine to, like, make the project, like, I feel like, I don't know. Kendrick's never been, like, a very traditional rapper, you know? He's not going to get a tight beat from YouTube for 4 minutes and then just give, like, three verses and choruses and go. Like, you know what I'm saying? It was always very traditional. He was very non-traditional. He would have beat switches and different voices and maybe never even have a chorus, maybe just rap or whatever, like, you know? But I felt like on the other albums, there was more, like, I don't know, you get songs like Feel, or you get songs like fucking The Art of Peer Pressure. Like, you know, those songs are non-traditional, but, like, at the same time, though, they still felt like songs. I felt like he could be as unorthodox as he wanted, but it still fit in the theme of the song. The production still kept you tapped in, like, very focused. Like, I like the soapbox thing. Like, I really feel like he's just getting in front of me and just, like, being, like, almost like a motivational speaker. You know what I'm saying? And it's just, like, I don't want to say it's corny, but it's just, like, it's just giving really preachy vibes. And it's really, like, you could tell, like, on the cover, like I said, with the crown of the, with the thorns and shit. Like, you know, it's really giving Messiah complex, like, hear the thy people type shit. You know what I'm saying? And it's, like, I don't know, like, I liked the other way, the other ways on the previous albums, he would delve into topics and talk about shit, and it didn't feel like that. It just felt natural. It just felt like he was really creating music, but also, like, delivering messages. Last song, Mirror. It's gotta be hard. It's the last song. You gotta come with some shit.
I choose me.
This nigga yak, bro.
Ready, I redirect it. Point of view, you won't grow away.
It's toxic, girl, I'm not relevant to giving them profit. Personal gain of my pain is nonsense. Darling, my demons is off the leash for a mosh pit. Folks, she say I'm trifling, disregarding the way that I cope with my own vices. Maybe it's time to break it off, run away from the culture to follow my heart. I realize you love.
Go ahead.
Oh no, I've just been letting you talk. Okay, like, I wasn't too crazy about that song. It was just okay. Like, another song that I thought was just very okay. But I feel like it was a good ending with, I guess, with the theme of the album. I guess since he's been talking about how all this stuff has been affecting him and the way he's been thinking and just shit like that, I just feel like him being like, I choose me, I'm sorry. It's just him being like, shit. I've already given you, like, I guess, like, reasonings and explanations, I guess, if that makes sense. And now he's just like, this is my story and I'm sticking to it.
Song wasn't really, I mean, it was a nice message or whatever, but once again, like, very repetitive. The verse was the best part of it. I like that verse a lot. I like that verse a lot. Everything else. Yeah. It was a nice message, but it's just like, at the end of the day, like, ultimately, like, your shit has to be, like, listenable.
I feel like that's the theme for the whole album, though. Like, the message in almost every song is powerful and it's insightful and it's there. I just feel like he's talking at me and not making something that I want to hear.
This shit just, like, wasn't
really... What am I gonna... Why would I get in the car and put that on?
This shit was just not really musical, and, like, the parts that weren't musical weren't that fire. I didn't. I expect
the features.
I expected to, like, knock some shit over this video. I thought I was gonna get up, have to pause it like 20 times in the middle because nigga was going crazy.
It was very boring.
And it's just, yeah, like,
it was kind of hard to keep my attention throughout this project.
I should have known something was up when it was 18 songs. See, I told niggas. Once you get to that, you pass like 15, 16, it get a little spooky. I was really hoping for like 14, like 7 and 7.
I would have been fine with like 10, honestly.
Well, I mean, knowing what this album is, I would be fine with like, you know, 7. But I'm saying that's like fair. Just in general, before I even heard anything, like just, you know, like 14 is like a very good album, like 13, 14.
I think it's just very hard, first of all, to have a double album that can keep people's attention the whole time.
I don't even really know what difference I'm getting from the first side and the second side. Disregard whatever I said about my idea.
Yeah, I thought it would be like each side would have a theme.
Disregard whatever I said about my ideas about each side. I don't know what it is. This could have been 1 through 18 for me, and I probably still would have dissected it the same. Not to be ignorant, I'm sure a lot of people, you know, the think piece, you know, super...
The think piece warriors.
The dissect podcast is probably going to have a field day with figuring out the deeper meaning behind the sides.
I don't know. I really just want to love it because... I've been wanting new music from Kendrick for so long, but it's just like...
Kendrick, you my guy. You still my favorite, but I am underwhelmed.
I hope Kendrick is protecting his peace. And I hope that he like has a sense of relief, though, that he put it all out there. So, I mean, carrying around that much inside and not talking about it is probably exhausting. But if you guys enjoyed this video, which I hope you did, please give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe, comment down below anything you like. What are your thoughts of the album? Honestly.
Please let me know.
Are we tripping?
Let's talk about it. Dialogue.
As per usual, follow all my socials. They'll be linked in the description bio. It's 3:00 in the morning. We're going to bed. I hope you all enjoyed the commentary from Nelson. I kind of stopped talking after a while on purpose to let him have it because this is his man's. So, yeah, well.
She didn't have to do that. She could have just, you know, it's her video, it's her channel, you know?
Well, I mean, the way you were carrying on, I didn't want to stop you in mid-rant. We'll see you guys next time. Bye!